Praise the Lord. A very good morning to you, my brothers and sisters.
Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. Good morning.
We continue with the series on youth. I've got another fellow who's young. My very own son, Rohit, with me. Okay? And now, we're going to ask him some questions as well as to why he wants to remain connected with Jesus. Rohit, tell me something. When did you first experience Jesus?
Well, the first time I experienced Jesus was when Brother Johnson came here.
Yes.
And he shared the Word of God so beautifully.
Correct.
And after that, the experience has been just lovely. The healings, the miracles that have happened in my life and the people around me that come to Upper Room Ministries.
Right.
It's just been wonderful and the experience is great being with Jesus.
Being with you. You remember you went for two trips to
Uganda.
Tell us something about Uganda.
Well, Uganda is, as everybody knows, that Uganda is in Africa and it's a very poverty-stricken country.
Yes.
And but still the people there are very loving, very generous, and they share, even though they don't have themselves anything to give, they share the very little that they have, they share.
That's right.
That's the greatest thing that I've seen in these people. Yeah.
And how was the convention? How did they come as if they want to meet Jesus and all that conventions?
Oh yes, there were a lot of people that came. Even people who didn't believe, they used to come and just to listen to the Word of God, they were there.
Wow.
Yeah.
People from all sides.
Yes, sir, from all sides.
And there was a lot of people who did black magic also who came.
Yes, a lot of people, a lot of witches as they call them.
Witches.
Yeah.
Oh, they also came.
Yes, they were there.
And during the prayers, what happened?
I remember in one of the sessions, during the mass that the father held in Uganda, he held up the Eucharist like
Correct.
This, and there were people who literally fell down and were rolling on the ground because
the power of the
Eucharist was there.
Wow, really?
Yes.
Fantastic. So that was another experience for you, right?
Yeah.
Well, what is the present thing? What do you feel you should do for Jesus? What are you doing for Jesus now?
I think many of you people know that I do a lot of editing work for Upper Room Ministries, and I just want to continue on that path.
Yes.
And to touch as many lives as possible through my work.
Amen, amen, amen. Now you know one thing, what I would like to come in here is, Rohit at the moment has changed his laptop, bought a very highly sophisticated laptop just to see that it adds up to the daily word that comes to you. He is so good with the laptop and he is so good in putting up everything, the PowerPoint presentations for the Friday, the daily word is done by him, the daily word is edited, everything is done. There's another person, another brother called Rian, he's another young person who is doing all the other technical work in the room, and we are all geared up. See, this is what we should learn at this age. Rohit, you are about 60, 70, what's your age now? 29, okay. Rohit is 29 only. And at this age, he is so much involved in working for the Lord. So much involved to see that the word goes out and touches people's lives. But we want this to happen. You people also can do a lot if you just let the Lord walk into your life and do it for the Lord. I never knew my son had so many talents. But one by one, when he came up, he started showing his talents. And this, mind you, he has not gone to any computer school or has he gone to any other this thing. Today, what he is doing is learning by himself and developing on that. So that is how Jesus works. When Jesus loves his child, when he has taken him to Uganda twice, along with Brother Johnson, and there he could see the miracles and wonders happen. Just now, as he told you, when the Eucharist was held high during Mass, the people would start rolling around the place in Uganda. That is the power of our Jesus. And what would you like to tell the youth today? Should they come to the Lord or should they?
Oh, definitely they should come and experience the Lord, because he has a lot to, I mean, he loves everybody equally, and the love that you will experience with him, you will never experience in this world.
Amen, amen. With that beautiful line, you will never experience anything like that in this world. We leave you with that. Think over it. Anybody needs any help, come to us. We will see what we can do and we will help you out to get connected to the Lord. May the Holy Spirit go out with you today. May you have a wonderful day. God bless you all and have a great day.
Have a great day, brothers and sisters. God bless.
Thank you.